So I've probably described it in quite great detail, but it's a high volatility to low volatility utilizing the Hunt Volatility Funnel, which is a bespoke setup that I've developed that I believe is universally easy to use, easier to use than almost any other trade strategy for new, intermediate and advanced traders. And I teach it as well.
How do you scan for trades?
Combination of searches, algorithmic searches at the moment. I'm also developing actually and going to be testing actually algo doing the actual trading as well. At the moment it's just a scan process. And then observation. I look at certain markets where they've already been creating patterns and I go back to them and look for more, because often something that is trending that keeps generating continuation patterns keeps doing that on the way, all the way along as it makes its way up.
And how do you monitor your trading?
From within the P&L of the broker statement, and then a larger personal Excel sheet, because I have a number of accounts and I have option accounts and various things. So the balances of those are consolidated into a personal document. So that's how you should be able to do it. Most platforms have more than suitable P&L based summaries for you.
When you enter a trade, what signals are you looking for?
A key breakout of a key level that I've defined.
How do you find high probability trade levels?
Where the market has shown you a key level of significance and its price behavior has reacted to that. Observe those levels and then trade any clear impulsive move above or below those levels.
What indicators do you use?
Volume where available I'll use as an indicator. And volatility measuring tools, such as Bollinger Bands that I've already mentioned. And I also like OBV, which is a cumulative weighted volume summary, which shows whether it's being net accumulated or disaccumulated as a stock.
Which moving averages do you use and what not to do?
So moving averages are not a tool I feel I need at all, but in the early days, it's worth having people playing with them just so that they can ascertain trend until they're really familiar with Dow theory and what means an uptrend and a downtrend. And they should preferably have the slower ones on. I wouldn't trade them, treat them as informational. Many things are informational but non-tradable. Tradable, the quality of criteria to be actively tradable is, should be far more precise than most people consider. So it's merely informational and telling you that largely over a certain time frame, this market is generally spending more time going up. That's all the information it gives you. If you take the intercepts as trade signals, as I've said before, moving average strategies don't make money over the long run because the markets don't trend often enough.
How do you choose the ideal period setting for moving average lines across different markets?
So as I'm not a heavy user of moving averages, I don't have opinions on cross markets and I'm purely interested in identifying the trend, and usually from just price behavior observationally, I can see that now. So for me, a moving average is almost like, and this is going to sound derogatory to those that use it, but I consider them like kids' additional cycling wheels, the kiddie wheels to support a child on the cycling. For the time that you can't balance and you can't actually immediately decipher what the key trend is, here's a tool for you to do it. Once you can see from looking at a chart what the trend is, the value add of those wheels are actually detrimental. They cause additional friction, and they're not good trading signals on general. You can always find an optimized moment where they've given you, but if you use them on the whole term going forward, they fall, too many false signals, and the markets are too choppy. And getting the right value moving average, you can optimize for a certain piece of data, then going forward it's out of optimization. So it's just a non-utilizable tool for me for trade.
Tell us about your crossover moving average trading strategy.
So I understand the crossover moving trading strategy, and I have no faith in it to consistently deliver returns, and I'd advise people against trading it with real money, although as part of their research and grounding and learning, there's no harm in treating it as an experience to be had. A bit like a kid falling out the tree, it's all part of growing up. Is it something you choose to do on a regular basis? No.
Okay, would you define yourself as a discretionary trader, a mechanical trader, or a combination of the two?
Combination of the two. So I aspire to greater systemic approach. However, even when defining everything in code, I can sometimes see something that I don't like in a particularly identified thing logic-wise that tells me I need to do more coding and refreshing. That's a discretionary interruption or interference with a system. And occasionally, I think I'm a bit both. So I'd like to, the refinement process requires you to continually to make observations and apply discretion to refine your system. So there is certain things a human mind can detect sometimes that has a value add. So I haven't totally gone the whole hog, robot hog.